Okay, so we need to add our slideshow to our Trekkers Travel website. So in order to do this, let's look at the website as it is now. Yours might be at a different stage. It could be you're at the end and everything is built except for the slideshow, or you could be at the beginning where maybe you don't have the navigation done or whatnot. The point you do need to be at is you need to at least have all of your divs set so that we have a div to add our slideshow to. So when you have that created, we can start creating the slideshow. So let's see what we have. First of all, this is in my programs WoW slider, and you can open up the WoW slider. Now this is free, but it's gonna give some WoW slider logos and whatnot on it. And that's okay because we're just practicing with this. But at the same time, if you like this type of slideshow for your own website, you'll need to buy the pro version. Okay, so in our Trekkers root folder, we should have an images folder, and in that folder we have a folder called slideshow, and it has all of the slideshow images. And each of these images, if you right click and choose properties, it should tell you, and maybe it doesn't tell you on a PC, on a Mac it does, but it should tell you how big it is if you hover over it. So it's 960 by 300. So we took these into Photoshop, made them the perfect size, made sure that they had a good balance of resolution with file size. You can see none of them are usually above 100K, and we tried to keep them under 80. So let's go ahead and see what we need to do. But before, in your very first Trekkers Travel folder you got in Chapter 1, you should have had a folder in there called Designer Files. In that Designer Files, you'll find a PDF that explains what each of these pictures is, because you will need to add these captions to your photos. And it also tells you that in the example site, I use the theme Terse and the effect Blur. And again, it's 960 by 300. So let's go ahead and start working on this. We need to drop our images here. So let's go ahead and highlight all of these and drop them in. And then it's going to ask you different things about each one of these. So the title of it, URL, is where it should go. So if somebody's going to click on this and it's going to take them to like a Thailand website, then you can put it here. If it's not clickable, if you don't want it to link to anything, then you don't have to put anything here. So if I want to add a description, let me look. I think, oops, I just shut that PDF. So this is called Adaman C, and I can put Thailand. And this is the Brooklyn Bridge, so the title, Brooklyn Bridge. And we could get a little bit more descriptive at sunset, New York City, New York. So I can't remember what this one is. I think they're a couple getting married in Bali, Indonesia. So Bali, Indonesia. So you want it to be consistent. So this one should have been Adaman C, comma Thailand, and I should have put something like tranquil getaway. And this one I should have said edgy urban vacation, and then Brooklyn Bridge, New York, or NYC. So anyway, once you get all of that description done, then you need to do a couple things. First of all, here's where you can add images, you can delete images, and you can move up selected images. So if I wanted Japan to come first, I could just click and drag, or I can do this up or down over here. So publish, we don't want to do that yet. That is, we're done, we're ready to put it somewhere. So here's where you can save this actual WoW slider that you're working on, and here's where you can open one and create a new one. So we just want to go to properties right now. So slider title, our, let's see, Trekkers slideshow. And you can choose different options. So should it autoplay, or should it pause when somebody puts their mouse over it? You can tell it if it should have bullet navigation, which has like little dots that people can move through, or film strip navigation. Now, I've built the site with a certain theme and size in mind, so I recommend that you choose the settings I choose, or that if you're comfortable playing with your CSS, then once you get that slideshow in, you'll just have to accommodate things with different sizes. So we just need the bullet navigation. As for the images, I use the terse theme, and unfortunately this is not in alphabetical order, so it's irritating. And we did 960 by 300. It's really important that you choose the right size here. And then we want to preserve the aspect ratio. We don't have to worry because we edited these in Photoshop. So now what we need to do is just choose our transition effect. So I just did blur because it's a lot, I don't know, it's a lot cleaner to me. And then if we want to publish it, we can publish it to a folder. We can put it on a server, or we can insert it to a page. Thankfully, we already have our page built, so we're going to insert it to a page. So we're going to go ahead and do browse. And it tells you, open your HTML page, click inside the page to select where you want your gallery to appear, then click insert before. Okay, so we're going to have to find our Trekkers Travel site. Here's our page, and click open. And it's going to try to show us our page. And we're going to click in here. And click on the paragraph, that P tag, because we still want it to be in this div, but we want it to be in here. So we'll do insert before. And it's going to try to show you where it's going to be. And don't worry that it kind of looks funky. So we'll hit publish. And now it's added it in there. Now the only problem with this is that, and we will fix the positioning later, you can see that down here we don't actually need that text. So with that page open, let's go ahead and close. Do you want to reload it? Yes. So now if we go down to that div for the slideshow, see we have div ID slideshow, and it has a note start while slider here. So then it says end while slider here, and we just need to get rid of this slideshow paragraph. So let's go ahead and save it and launch it in Firefox. And now we're going to change our website so that it can't stretch out here and we don't see the orange. But now our page looks good. So as you can see for all of these, here's the bullet navigation down here. So if I click on the first one, and it might not be where, okay, Adamansi, Thailand. So the title is going to show up as the big one on top. And then the description is going to show up smaller down here. So if you had a longer description, then that would be okay. So anyway, that's the basics of adding the slideshow. And if you run into any trouble, you can always come in here to your HTML, get rid of all this stuff. So if I got rid of all this, so from the start of this start while slider to the end of this end while slider, get rid of that, put a paragraph back in there because that's easy for us to be able to say put it before this paragraph. Come back into our slideshow, fix a couple of things, and hit publish again. And not this publish because it'll just, oh yeah, you can do this. So anyway, you can keep repeating it until you get your slideshow correct. It's just that every single time you have to delete the code that was previously created.